My name is Lynne Nemeth. I'm an associate professor of nursing at the Medical University of South Carolina, and I'm an investigator in PPRNet, which is a practice-based research network. In our pilot study, we implemented electronic standing orders into the daily workflow of 8 primary care practices from around the country. A standing order authorizes nursing or other clinical staff to act on and execute a medical order without a clinician's exam. We used patient information from an electronic healthcare record, also known as an EHR, to develop a standing order protocol for 15 screening, immunization, and diabetes care measures. This approach engaged all members of the primary care team, empowered the clinical staff, and activated patients to participate in their own health care.
I'm Dr. Stephen Johnson. I'm the senior doctor in New London Family Practice. Before the SoTrip project, our medical assistants actually had a fairly limited role in patient care. They would just take patients' blood pressures, ask them why they were here in 4 words or less, and come out of the room.
We did this project because we know that time constraints and competing obligations undermine the delivery of preventive services. And health IT can be an important way to improve preventive and chronic care. We use the health maintenance table of the EHR to record the services that were due for the patient based on age, gender, and medical process or diagnosis that they had. And any of the needed procedures for the patient would show up in red, indicating that they were due to be addressed at that visit. New London exhibited a very successful response to this study's implementation, and they provide a good exemplar story of how primary care practices can improve on measures that they're concerned with.
But we saw this as an opportunity to expand what they did, to empower them and to involve them more in the patient care. The medical assistants also, by doing that, feel more involved. They get more connected with the patients. They take more pride in their work, and I think overall contributes to a morale boost for the office, so it's a win-win.
My name is Teresa Jump, and I'm a medical assistant, and I was one of the liaisons on the research project. I went to 3 conferences to learn about the project, to take it back and teach it to my coworkers.
My name is Meredith. I'm a medical assistant here. When I first heard about the project, I was a little nervous because of the extra work, but I was excited because it would give us more one-on-one time with the patient instead of just, you know, putting them in a room. I'm also talking to them more about their health and get more of a sense of, like, empowerment. Some people would think you're just a medical assistant, but I think we do so much, and people don't really know what goes on behind the scenes, really.
Dr. Johnson has the patient's chart set up, so when you click it open, everything that the patient's due for will be red. And the whole idea is when you get them up to date, the red comes out. And every time a patient has all the red out of their chart, we get a gold star. And so many gold stars lead to prizes.
Now it's a focus in the practice to do it all the time. It's in front of our faces every time we open the chart. So even if a person is here for a cold or the flu, if they're due for a shot, the medical assistant just orders it, so it doesn't take any more time, and these things get done.
So, as you know, one of the things that we try to do is not only look for things that are wrong, but prevent other bad things from happening. We talked about exercise already, that's the main thing. Mm-hmm. Taking off a couple of pounds, your tetanus shot's all set, and we're going to do some blood work on you.
Okay.
Our patients are benefiting by getting all the health maintenance procedures that they should have. One good example, I think, is the shingles vaccine, which I think in a lot of practices is on the back burner. And so our numbers are pretty good for that. And I've had enough patients who've gotten shingles after refusing the vaccine to know that we're helping a whole lot of folks.
At the end of the study, across all practices, 6 of the 15 measures were significantly improved. I feel this is important because we're not utilizing all of the staff to their fullest potential, in the healthcare system without standing orders. Primary care providers are very busy. They have a lot of competing demands. Patients have their own agendas too, so that when they come in to see a provider for a regular visit, these are things that can be addressed very easily rather than wait for it to be brought up independently. So this really just provides a natural segue into improving the delivery of preventive services.